Hello everyone and welcome to OLAN Technologies' presentation on tips to improve network security. With the increasing number of network security threats coming from the internet, network administrators need to keep one step ahead of cyber attackers. In today's presentation, I'll give you some tips to help you better protect your router and data network. My name's Darren and I'm the Queensland sales rep at DrayTek Australia and New Zealand. Here I have an outline of the topics I'll be covering today. We'll start with a short introduction of what a cyber attack is and how it can affect your network and organisation. Then we'll look at the security features built into DrayTek routers and how you can use these to protect your network. And we'll look at a case study. If you have any questions during the video, please comment in the chat box on the right side of the screen and stick around at the end for a 5-minute Q&A session. Don't forget you can pause the video or skip back anytime if you'd like a longer look at anything or to hear it again. If you're watching this after the live premiere, please comment below or send an email to sales@draytech.com.au. So, cyber attacks. What are they and what can we do about them? Here's a definition of the term cyber attack. Essentially, a cyber attack is an attempt to gain access to your network from the internet with the goal of disrupting, disabling, destroying, or gaining control of your network infrastructure. The main aim of cyber criminals in most cases is to steal personal or financial information for financial gain. There are many methods used by cyber criminals to gain access to or disrupt your network and services. These include denial of service attacks, phishing attacks, ransomware, malware, MITM attacks, whale phishing attacks, spear phishing attacks, password attacks, SQL injection attacks, as well as many others not listed here. Every day we hear in the news that there has been a cyber attack on some organisation somewhere in the world. Just recently, even Microsoft's email servers were attacked. So there's a constant need to harden the security of your network. Cyber attacks can come from different angles, as mentioned previously. One of them, denial of service attacks, can cause your server to become inaccessible from the internet. Spoofing attacks attempt to log into your router or even attempt to gain access through your VPN connections. So what can we do about it? Let's look at what we can do to improve network security. Firewalls are usually the first line of defense to protect your network. They establish a barrier between secured and controlled internal networks that can be trusted and untrusted outside networks, such as the internet. It's important to remember that firewalls cannot protect against viruses coming from infected media, such as an infected office document that a staff member might bring in on a USB flash drive. This will circumvent any security measures you have in place and requires the use of antivirus software installed on PCs to minimize this risk. DrayTek routers have several features which can protect against threats from the internet. These features are free and do not need any license fees, except if you want to use Siren Web Content Filter, which is updated on a daily basis by Siren. Most of these are easy configuration changes which can help with network security, while others are built-in features that only need to be enabled. Let's go over each of these in more detail. First up, DrayTek release regular firmware updates. Ensure your router has the latest firmware version installed, as it usually includes the latest security patches. For example, the most recent security fix in the latest firmware is to protect against Wi-Fi frag attacks. This vulnerability can be used to steal user information or attack devices. You can find out more about frag attacks at the link shown here, which I'll include in the description below. So it is important to ensure your router always has the latest firmware version installed. If you need to access the router remotely to manage it, then it's recommended to restrict access to only known sources. You can do this by using the access list function in the System Maintenance Management tab. This way, only the IP addresses listed in the access list will be able to get access. Beware not to block yourself out while doing this. When accessing the router management page over a VPN connection, you can also restrict access by entering the peer IP address of the VPN connection. This will be the IP address of the PC at the other end of the tunnel. This way, only authorized users will be able to access the router management page. Another option you can use is to enable the validation code option, which appears when you try to log into the router admin web user interface. Each time anyone then tries to log into the router, they will need to enter the temporary code that appears. This can protect the router from bot attacks, where an automated bot or application continues to try a list of passwords found in a password list. Given enough time, any common password can be cracked, but if you need to enter a validation code with each attempt, then the job becomes much more difficult. While this still may not provide 100% protection, the idea is to make the job much harder so that the hacker moves on to find an easier target. Two-factor authentication provides strong protection against hacking, so it's a good idea to take advantage of it whenever it is available. This option is found in the Vigor ACS 2 or 3 network management platforms. It makes use of an app on a smartphone, which makes it easier to sync the second factor of authentication. You may have come across two-factor authentication before, where you receive a validation code via a text message to your mobile phone number. That code then has to be entered, along with the correct username and password, in order to gain access. In a moment, I'll also go over another instance where two-factor authentication can be used in remote dial-in VPN connections using DrayTek Smart VPN client. Another tip is to change the management ports in the router. The default ports are well known, so changing the values to different numbers will make it more difficult for hackers to guess. However, a more secure way to manage your router remotely is to disable management from the internet completely and use VPN to access the router management page. It's also recommended to enable brute force protection in the management setup page. Brute force protection for VPN will be introduced in an upcoming firmware version. An example of a brute force attack I mentioned already when talking about validation codes. These are when a hacker tries to log into the router remotely and they have no idea what the password is, so they'll try every possible passphrase until eventually the correct login password is found. Enabling brute force protection allows the router to identify an IP address that has failed many login attempts and block them for a set period. DOS, denial of service, is a networking attack which makes devices unavailable by flooding them with fake connection requests. These attacks are usually categorized into two types, flooding type attacks and vulnerability attacks. Flooding type attacks will attempt to exhaust all your system's resources, while vulnerability attacks will try to paralyze a system by taking advantage of vulnerabilities of a protocol or operating system. The DOS defense functionality in DrayTek routers helps detect and mitigate a DOS attack. The example shown here is using UDP flood defense, as well as a blacklist to detect a UDP attack from the internet or IP address in the blacklist. When detected, that source will be blocked for the duration of the timeout period. The network administrator can also be alerted anytime this happens. You should also disable any unneeded VPN services. This closes some doors for hackers. In later firmware versions, DrayTek have disabled some of these services by default, so you will need to enable the required service if you need to use it. Similarly, you should always disable unused services such as Telnet, SNMP, SSH, and so on. You can even limit access to the management console to certain LAN subnets. Syslog is a very powerful tool that will record a lot of events and will sometimes show attempts to start a VPN tunnel or the IP address of a possible attacker. A USB flash drive is adequate to collect the logs from the router. If collecting syslogs, it's a good idea to ensure that the correct time and date is configured in the router so that the syslog entries will have the correct timestamp. This helps to work out when an event occurred. It's good practice to check the router syslogs on a regular basis to check if there have been attempts to gain access to your network. Here's an example of an attempted login attempt from the internet. Here's another example of an attempted VPN login attempt. All of those maximum retries exceed messages indicate a possible brute force attack and will give you an idea of what to look for when checking the syslogs. Another good idea is to make passwords as long as possible. It's now more and more encouraged to use sentences or several common words stuck together to make it longer. According to a number of security experts, just having a sentence as your password can create a nightmare for hackers. The advantage in using a sentence is that it's much easier to remember than a string of random characters, and it's also more secure when used in the proper manner. In addition to using secure passwords, it's also recommended to change them on a regular basis. That way, if anyone has managed to guess one, they'll be cut off and have to start the process all over again. Do that often enough and they're not likely to keep trying. Another tip I mentioned earlier is to consider using two-factor authentication for web or MOTP, mobile one-time password, for dial-in VPN login connections. The MOTP app, which can be downloaded and installed on your smartphone, manages the time-based authentication and password response with its securely held MOTP secret. The end user doesn't need to know the MOTP secret value, just the username and four-digit PIN code. To connect the VPN tunnel, the user enters their VPN username and one-time VPN password, which is generated by entering their PIN into the MOTP app. Security certificates. Bigger routers allow administrators to create and sign a custom security certificate for SSL VPN and HTTPS connections. Due to security concerns, it's strongly recommended to have a unique private key on each device for self-signed SSL. A recommended practice in the event of an attack is to re-sign and change the default security certificates just in case they were compromised. More details on how to generate a customized self-signed certificate and then replace the default one on Vigor routers is covered in Knowledgebase article 5135 in the link shown here. I'll include that link in the description below. Okay, let's take a look at an actual case that happened recently. This one came up after repeated cyber attacks against a company's IT infrastructure gateways. The solution here was to increase security on the border routers. This involved limiting access to the IT network by using restrictive VPN protocols IPsec X.509 or SSL plus MOTP. In addition, any unnecessary ports and services were closed to reduce the chance of cyber attacks. The recommendation to branch officers is shown here in the newsletter that went out. This includes using the latest firmware and using strong passwords for admin logins, as well as all VPN profiles, also changing them often. Other recommendations shown here were disabling any services and unnecessary VPN profiles, enabling brute force protection, recording the syslog and setting up VPN and login mail alerts for it, then reviewing the logs periodically, re-signing and changing the default security certificates, and using higher level security for VPN connections. Here we have some knowledge-based articles which provide additional information in improving network security. Those links will be found in the description below as well. So to summarise, today we briefly looked at what cyber attacks are and what steps you can take to protect your router and your network from these attacks. This included looking at what security features are available in DrayTek routers. We also looked at a case study and provided a list of some knowledge-based articles you can look at, which provide additional information. Okay, that's it for me, but please stay tuned. Our technical team will be answering questions in the live chat on the right of your screen for the next 5 minutes. For more information about DrayTek products, please check out our website at www.draytek.com.au or send us an email to sales@draytek.com.au or give us a call on 02983888899. Please like and subscribe below, and if you'd like a notification of new premiere videos we're about to launch or any time we put up a new video, please give the bell a click too. Thanks and bye for now. Thank you.
Thank you.